I quit the civil services and I set up the Rann Samar Foundation. See, empowerment is something which gives you the courage to decide what you want to do in life. It gives you the conviction to take on the world. Empowerment is also if you are capable of controlling crime against you. Education alone would not be able to do it. For that, definitely we need to come together. Today, girls who go to school, 89% of them have to do the household work before they can come to school and read. That is the spirit of womanhood. That the main initiative that Rann Samar is taking in Uttar Pradesh is trying to provide fees, books for the girls who drop out of school because their parents are poor. We have girls who go missing, maybe due to feticide, maybe due to reproduction problems, maybe due to infant mortality, maternal mortality, so many reasons. But feticide is something which we have not taken care of. You are concerned about the human rights of the rapist, you are concerned about the human rights of the criminals, but you are not concerned about those little girls. We are way behind countries like Bangladesh, countries like Afghanistan, where there was death penalty for acid attack. But what I want as a lawyer, what I want as a public servant, because I've seen how the government works, it is more than the punishment, it is the speedy punishment, it is the certainty of punishment which is going to make our women safe. Today when a woman goes out, she is told, don't wear jeans, don't carry a mobile. These are the khap type statements which are given out, and crime is attributed to her character. And this is the real position. India lacks meritocracy. You have to be a relative of a politician, you have to be a daughter of a politician. We have tokenism. We say India had a prime minister for 18 years, 17 years, but we forget that Indira Gandhi also was a daughter of a prime minister.
Supreme Court judges out of 25 male Supreme Court judges. What is equality? The issue of triple talaq was being decided by a 5-member bench. It did not have a single woman judge. That means even today the men decide that they are going to decide for us, not us.
Education empowers. But true empowerment will come when we are safe. We can take decisions. How many of us can decide how to spend the money we earn? Let me tell you, the UN figures say that 20%, world over, only 20% women have land in their name, when you are 50% of the population. Today, we are ashamed to ask for a share. Today, we are ashamed to say we are independent, because immediately the society will pounce on us that we are greedy and we are asking for property. I was just watching one of the speeches of Jack Ma at Davos, and he said that if you want an organization to be successful, get more women, because women are wise. And the first time I found a mindset of a person, no wonder Alibaba is so successful, because when your chairman and founding father says that women have more EQ, they have LQ. So I want the politicians of this country to take a lesson or two from your founder, from the chairman of Alibaba, who says that to have an organization successful, get more women on board.
This government has definitely worked, but there is much more to be done.
Don't want 33%, nothing. We want that mindset. We want the patriarchy to end. We want to have the mindset that if a woman is successful, give her her due place. Thank you so much.